Welcome to FAULHABER. In this video, I want to show you how to actually connect our motors to our drivers. And I want to start with a MC3005 and a 32mm BX4 motor here. So there are different options. First of all, of course, here with the flat ribbon cable, you got the motor faces and the hall signals. And you could, of course, separate these two and attach the appropriate connectors here on the motor side, so for the motor faces and for the linear halls, and then plug them into the driver. Second would be, well, you could actually buy a motor which already has the correct connectors, like this one here. Or use one of the extension cables that we got in our accessories program here, and plug the motor into the one side of the cable and then the correct connectors into the driver on the other side. Here in this example, I'm using simply a self-made adapter cable with the appropriate connectors here and connect them to the hall signals and the motor faces. Next is the supply side. Motor supply and the electronic supply, and I'm using an industrial grade power supply here and can connect them. And whenever the voltage range of my power supply is fitting to the configuration of the driver, the green power good LED will be lit while the status LED is blinking here. For configuration, I'll need to add at least one communication interface, and again for the field bus here there is a prepared adapter cable available, and we plug this into the field bus connection and then connect it to the PC. Next would be connecting the same BX4 motor to an MC3004. These MC3004 are usually plugged into whatever custom designed motherboard, here one carrying up to four of these drivers. In this case, there's a single connector for the motor, so motor faces and linear halls combined in one connector. That's a standard connector for our motors here. And what I have to do is to connect the motor into this single connector here, and then add the power supply, once again using this industrial grade 24 volt supply. So the electronic connection here and the power supply for the motors, and then once again the power good LED and the status LED are blinking here. And to finally connect it to the PC, I would have to add again the communication cable here. Next is a motor having the prepared connectors for the digital halls and the motor faces, and it's having an incremental encoder additionally. So in that case, I'm going to use all three connectors on the motor side. And I can directly plug the motor faces into the driver and, of course, the holes. But my encoder is equipped with the wrong connector here. I can't plug this directly into my motion controller. And in such a case, I can use a prepared adapter here. This one is having a connector here for my 10-pole DIN connector here. So plug it into the adapter, and then using the adapter I can hook it up to the encoder connector of the driver here. And then of course, once again, add power, add communications and start tuning. Next would be our MC3001, so the small one here. And usually when you want to start, you're going to use one of our carrier boards here, prepared carrier board, and have to plug the driver into the board here. And then in this case here, I'm using a motor having the prepared connectors for the linear halls and the motor faces. So plug these ones into the carrier board here. And then what I need to do is add supply and the communication interface. So once again, my supply here, and the status LED is starting to blink, and then I can add the communication here. Alternatively, of course, I can directly hook it up with a USB cable to the PC. So that's what I wanted to show in this video, so how to connect the different motors and drivers. Next video would be to actually configure such a drive using the Motion Manager. Thanks for watching and check out our channel.